Most people in America aren't familiar with what their job responsibilities and job description that's written encompasses. If you don't know what your job abilities are, if you don't know what your work accountabilities are, then you should be able to step up your life by simply giving a quick call to HR of your company or whoever your team leader might be, God forbid, and openly ask for a copy of the job description. Then you'll always know what your job is and isn't for your company underneath federal law. You see, job descriptions are typically required for every corporation that employs people. The reason is that it does allow people not to be aided and abetted in theft and abuses, and openly it also protects you from being claimed that you didn't do your job. Underperformance is a pretty standard thing for American citizens. If we can do as little as possible to get paid, we like in general to do that. We also like a lot of things for free. I mean, let's face it, we have a lot of stores that help our impoverished community, which is right for the American society. We haven't always had that. We always have had, in the past, the haves versus the have-nots, which has created incredible socioeconomic disparities, which made life in America a lot harder, a lot more in terms of civil war, where people were constantly being confiscated from by different war parties. But in America, we have the right to safety, and the right to safety is about saying, I have the right to safely shop in your store without your employees making me into some sort of joke or project or interest for your company. You see, every human being has the right to be anywhere in America. Every human being has the right to have a piece of space in America. Every human being has a right to find and seek shelter from the sun, shelter from the heat, shelter from the rain, shelter from the snow, shelter from the hail, shelter from a tornado, shelter. What we find fascinating is that American citizens can kind of be persnickety and picky about any kind of modest type of weather situation around people that might be in poverty, but if there's a severe situation of tornado, hurricane, then everybody cares whether or not you've got a place to be. The biggest disrespectful question that you can ask for to someone in poverty first out of your mouth is, where do you stay? In generally, people do not want to talk about it, and people do not want to tell you this. There's a lot of reasons, because there's predators in America. Predators that are immoral and predators that are illegal. The immoral predator wants to sic all their ideologies about your life from that two-second view of you on your life, of what they should do for you, what they could do for you, how they could do it behind your back, how they could live in the shadow life, how they could just interrupt your life and act like you're not an adult who doesn't know how to make decisions, doesn't know how to research things, doesn't know how to look for help, doesn't know how to do all these things. What a bunch of bullshit you just told yourself. Then there's illegal people. Illegal people, whether they're American citizens or foreign international people, have this idea, okay, when he gets home, I'm going after him. I'm going to take over his stuff. I'm going to steal his property. I'm going to ruin his computers. I'm going to take his clothes. I'm going to do all this shit. And no offense, that's none of your business. So if you're trying to produce yourself as a moral high ground citizen because you're some sort of Catholic, you're some sort of Christian, you're some sort of Lutheran, you're some sort of Methodist, you're some sort of Wiccan, you're some sort of, I don't know, Muslim, you're full of shit. You see, it doesn't really matter how many denominations I can remember from the book that I wrote on faith, as opposed to my reading from a huge world order chart that I utilized as one of my resources to do that work. But here's the deal. Your life is your life. Someone else's life is their life. Your family and friends are usually the people where you focus your interactions on. But when you have a chance to talk to a total stranger, a couple things you don't know going into it is who they are, where they came from, what they're about, what their goals are, what their life prospects are. You don't know that, and it's none of your fucking business. But if you see a person in poverty and you claim to be this great person of faith and spirituality and God loves everybody, great. But you're not listening to the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost might just say, hey, why don't you ask him this? Have you had any food today? That would be where I might begin. Or, more importantly, hey, I notice you're in struggle. And I say this all the time. Is there anything I could do with my finances or resources to help you? You see, when you bastardize the language and make it from your point of view, it usually comes out so fucking wrong to the person you're listening to that it's not even funny. But a generalized statement like that pretty much covers the gamut of any type of socioeconomic class that's impacted by poverty.